drugs can actually cure the flu.
$50, 8 minutes, and an earache. That is all it took to qualify for medical marijuana. In tonight's 10:15 Difference, Call 7 investigator Tony Kowaleski joins us with the results of a two-month hidden camera investigation. And Tony, Colorado voters approve marijuana for people with debilitating medical conditions.
And there are people who truly benefit from medical marijuana. Patients battling cancer, MS, and glaucoma. And that's how it was sold to voters. But now, those people are waiting months to get their certificates because the state is overwhelmed. Our investigation exposes the reason why.
In the state of Colorado, medical marijuana is legal. Okay, that's why you're here.
And that's why our hidden cameras found clinic waiting rooms packed and people lining up to gain access to legal marijuana.
I brought a stack of medical papers, you know. That was it, man. Within half an hour, I had a medical permit that I could buy.
He's a customer willing to help us understand what it takes to get this medical marijuana red card.
Chronic pain. Just say chronic pain?
Chronic pain from an injury long ago. Wake up with headaches, go to bed with headaches.
Just make it up?
The headache is impossible to prove.
Our hidden cameras also found workers in dispensaries and clinics coaching potential customers. At this location, a 7 News employee admitted to having no medical problem and no medical records.
If you don't have anything, you're more than welcome to go next door to the chiropractor, see if he can give you some sort of medical records.
At another location, a different recommendation to help build the required medical history.
Like, you can even go to Wikipedia or something and look up symptoms of migraines and just read them off in front of the doctor, you know? Just memorize them and say, like, oh, I've been getting, feels like my vision's just tunneling out, and 3 or 4 times a week, sometimes you wake up and it still hurts.
Voters approved medical marijuana nearly a decade ago. The law specifically requires a debilitating medical condition. To access medical marijuana, you must have one of these 8 conditions. The list includes cancer, glaucoma, and HIV/AIDS. You can see it does not include an earache.
In fact, the only medical record I showed them was for the earache.
He's a 7 News employee. We've disguised his identity to maintain his anonymity for future assignments. You told him you had an earache, and he gave you a license to buy marijuana. How long did that take?
It was 8 minutes tops.
Did the doctor challenge you in any way? Was he critical? Did he question you only have an ear infection and you want medical marijuana?
No, never once.
In fact, after $50 and the 8-minute examination, the doctor concluded the earache qualified as severe pain. Checked here on the official state document.
I would say that that's grossly inappropriate.
He's the executive director of the state health department. Department records show 90% of the Colorado residents with a red card qualified under the ambiguous category titled severe pain.
Do you think earache would be legit?
Any chronic pain.
Yeah,
as long
yeah.
As it's chronic.
Including things like headaches, backaches, migraines, and as we found out, even earaches.
This doctor said our producer can have a certificate for medical marijuana with an earache, and you can't stop that.
No, not today.
You're the attorney general. Do you have any power in this venue?
Not much.
And by all indications, that was not an accident. The state's medical marijuana amendment gives no oversight authority to the health department or the attorney general.
He spent 8 minutes with this doctor and received a certificate for medical marijuana.
It shows it's being abused, but no one should be surprised about that.
And that abuse is angering some patients we've spoken with who truly use medical marijuana as medicine. They're afraid the abuse that we've exposed will force lawmakers into passing strict controls on medical marijuana, making it tougher to legitimately get their medicine. Ann?
Well, Tony, I have to ask, what about our 7 News employee who qualified for a license?
Well, this is kind of interesting. Because of the state backlog, the 7 News employee has yet to receive his red card. He has a temporary card, but when we do get it, it will be destroyed. Ultimately, $50, 8 minutes, and an earache. That's all it took. Wow.
Fascinating. Thank you, Tony. Now, if you have something you want Tony or any of our investigators to check out, call 303-832-7777 or log on to thedenverchannel.com. Click on News Tips. You can also